Thank you, Mary Ann. In the name of Christ, welcome into the Lord's house as we gather for worship this morning. Also, hello to those of you joining us online, and we pray we don't lose you this morning, and the technology will continue to be what we need it to be as you join us online this morning as well. If you are a guest or visitor to our congregation, we welcome you. Pray the Lord's blessings be upon you, and if you have not been here before, we do invite you to sign our guest book and invite you to worship with us again. Our order of service for this morning is going to be the service of prayer and preaching. That will be on page 260 in the front portion of your hymnal. Since there is no confession absolution in this service, and we are having communion, when we get to the confession absolution down in the lower part of your service there, we'll be turning to pages 290 and 291, and I'll show you which parts we'll be doing when we get there today. Our opening hymn is 909. It is entitled, Christ Has Made the Sure Foundation. We will stand on the fourth and final verse. Make me to know your ways, O Lord. Sanctify us in your truth. From the rising of the sun to its setting,
the name of the
Lord is to be praised. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The Old Testament lesson for this 19th Sunday after Pentecost comes from Isaiah chapter 25 and can be found on the back of your worship folder. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wine, of rich food full of marrow, of aged wine well refined. And he will swallow up on his mountain the covering that is cast over all peoples, the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever, and the Lord God will wipe away tears from all faces, and the reproach of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, Behold, this is our God. We have waited for him that he might save us. This is the Lord. We have waited for him. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will join in reading the epistle lesson together. Also on the back of your worship folder from Philippians chapter 4, the verses are 4 through 13, and we read, Rejoice in the Lord always. Again I will say rejoice. Let your reasonableness be known to everyone. The Lord is at hand. Do not be anxious about anything. But in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, about these things, what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Practice these things, and the God of peace will be with you. I rejoice in the Lord greatly that now at length you have revived your concern for me. You were indeed concerned for me, but you had no opportunity. Not that I am speaking of being in need, for I have learned in whatever situation I am to be content. I know how to be brought low, and I know how to abound. In any and every circumstance, I have learned the secret of facing plenty and hunger, abundance and need. I can do all things through Him who strengthens me. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Will you please rise for the Holy Gospel? Holy Gospel is in St. Matthew, the 22nd chapter, verses 1 through 14. Again, Jesus spoke to them in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son and sent his servants to call those who were invited to the wedding feast, but they would not come. Again, he sent other servants, saying, 'Tell those who are invited, see, I have prepared my dinner, my oxen and my fat calves have been slaughtered, and everything is ready. Come to the wedding feast.' But they paid no attention and went off, one to his farm, another to his business, while the rest seized his servants, treated them shamefully, and killed them. The king was angry, and he sent his troops and destroyed those murderers and burned their city. Then he said to his servants, 'The wedding feast is ready, but those invited were not worthy. Go therefore to the main roads and invite to the wedding feast as many as you find.' And those servants went out into the roads and gathered all whom they found, both bad and good. So the wedding hall was filled with guests. When the king came in to look at the guests, he saw there a man who had no wedding garment. And he said to him, 'Friend, how did you get in here without a wedding garment?' And he was speechless. Then the king said to the attendants, 'Bind him hand and foot and cast him into the outer darkness. In that place there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. For many are called, but few are chosen.'" This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will continue our worship now with the responsory on page 263, and we will be doing the common responsory. Forever, O Lord, your word is firmly set in the heavens. Blessed are those who hear the word of God and keep it.
Lord, I love the habitation of your house and the place where your glory dwells.
Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
Lord, I love the habitation of your house and the place where your glory dwells.
Our catechism section will be the Ten Commandments. On the top of page 264, we say them together. You shall have no other gods. You shall not misuse the name of the Lord your God. Remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. Honor your father and your mother. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not give false testimony against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, or his manservant, or maidservant, his ox or donkey, or anything that belongs to your neighbor.
We confess our Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit,
we pray together.
for our hymn of the day, hymn 813. Our message is our Old Testament lesson from Isaiah 25, verses 6 through 9. Dear friends of Christ, I recently read a story about someone who was concerned that too many people live lives detached and devoid of emotional attachments with society. He decided to do something about it. Over the course of a year, he hosted 6 dinners at his home. Now, he would post his meal via social media and invite anyone who wanted to fill one of the 8 seats. Within 24 hours, all 6 evenings, all 48 seats were filled, and he even had a waiting list. The people who came each night did not know one another. They were politically, religiously, socially, and culturally different. ages were from 22 to 74, most evenings the dinner and conversation lasted 3 to 4 hours. Now the host later reflected there's something refreshing about sitting at a table and breaking bread with a stranger who is willing to let you into his or her personal space. He summarized his year-long experience with such a diverse group this way. People are hungry for connection, conversation, and community. Our text for today is from Isaiah. The Lord is throwing a dinner party. Open up your envelope. What does it say? You are invited to a gospel feast. Welcome. May I take your coat? Isaiah was God's chosen messenger to Judah. Now many years the times were good, but there was a spiritual void. These people struggled with the battles of life. They had personal problems, and there were political problems. Isaiah spoke judgment, and he wanted to bring about repentance. But Isaiah also spoke words of comfort and hope. And it all happened because of the sin in people's lives. Sometimes it was a result of their sinful actions that brought about tragic consequences. At other times, struggles ensued because it's the way of a sinful world and people were wondering why. Why? Have a seat. Let's talk. When was the last time you just let someone ask you questions about God? When was the last time you listened without judgment? When was the last time you just let someone express their thoughts and feelings without having to defend God or explain his actions? Sometimes people feel they're in ruin. They feel poor and needy. And as you listen, a connection is made. Let's sit down for dinner. Pick a chair. No assigned seats. Wow! What a feast! Fatty foods and aged wine were a delicacy at this time in history. Go ahead and fill up. Eat, drink, and be satisfied. What's that? You don't think you can? You've been trying to fill your life with other things? You've pursued the perfect job. You've spent money, but still have a void. You've tried to control everybody's life, while yours is spinning out of control. You are emotionally lost in these hectic times. The Lord of hosts says, that's why you were invited. I invited you here to tell you that all is not lost. You feel disconnected from your church and your co-workers and your family and your fellow students, and you're tired of watching worship online and sitting in front of a computer at your kitchen table. You don't want to take another online test or watch a lecture in your pajamas. Where is the community I used to know? The Lord swallowed up the covering. The disconnect that is cast over all peoples. The Lord has swallowed up the veil that darkens all nations. The Lord has swallowed up death forever. It is destroyed, it is consumed, and on the mountain, Calvary's mountain, Jesus was swallowed up by death. However, 3 days later, Jesus literally swallowed up death in his resurrection. Stop crying in your wine. You see, the Lord God's going to wipe away all your tears. Isaiah prophesies Revelation 7 when he says, "And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." Because death has been swallowed up, because of the lavishness of God's grace shown by the lavishness of the banquet feast, and because of the promise of eternal life, the Lord turns mourning into dancing. This is the gentle host, reassuring his people of his presence, his victory, his hope. What a message with which to connect people and where they are in their lives. And such connection creates community, the communion of saints. Who's ready for dessert? You've waited all night for it. Behold, this is our God. We have waited for Him that He might save us. This is the Lord. We have waited for Him. Let us be glad and rejoice in His salvation. We can't receive such a fabulous feast without an expression of thanks. God saved us. He saved us by inviting us to a gospel feast. He saved us by swallowing up death forever. He saved us by removing our disgrace. He connects us to Himself through word and sacrament in a world of disconnect. He is our community, the Lord of hosts who oversees all His creation. For all that and more, let us rejoice and be glad. Now, aren't you glad you came? Amen. We have the prayer printed out on page 265, and then I also have a few prayer requests as well this morning. In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the gift of divine peace and of pardon with all our heart, with all our mind, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the holy Christian church here and scattered throughout the world, and for the proclamation of the gospel and the calling of all the faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this nation, for our cities and communities, and for the common welfare of us all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For seasonable weather and for the fruitfulness of the earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who labor, for those whose work is difficult or dangerous, and for all who travel, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all those in need, for the hungry and homeless, for the widowed and orphaned, and for all those in prison, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the sick and dying, and for all those who care for them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the church, for the leaders of the church, for all pastors and missionaries. We also pray for a welcoming spirit in our congregation, for boldness in our invitation to those without a church home, and for a willingness to serve our neighbor in need and the stranger whose lives cross our paths. We also pray for all elected, appointed civil servants, judges, and magistrates, all emergency personnel, all members of the armed forces, and for us as citizens and neighbors. We also pray a prayer of thanksgiving this morning, Lord, for Sharon Hanner, the wife of Pete, who got some good news up in Chicago this week about her cancer. We pray that you continue to be with both Pete and Sharon and watch over them. Continue to see that Sharon's cancer continues to go into remission and guide and bless her. Through all this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
finally, for these and for all our needs of body and soul, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Lord of hosts, you have invited us to the feast. Help us to see your grace in the banquet set up for us. As you swallow death and wipe away tears, help us to be glad and rejoice through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Blessed Lord, you have caused all holy scriptures to be written for our learning. Grant that we may still hear them, read, mark, learn, and take them to heart. That by the patience and comfort of your holy word, we may embrace and ever hold fast the blessed hope of everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
We pray together the morning prayer at the top of page 266. I thank you, my Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have kept me this night from all harm and danger, and I pray that you would keep me this day also from sin and every evil, that all my doings in life may please you, for into your hands I commend myself, my body and soul in all things. Let your holy angel be with me, that the evil foe may have no power over me. Amen. I invite you now to turn to page 290 and 291. There you will find our corporate confession absolution. On the left-hand side, we will do the three sentences, and then we will skip over to the middle of page 291. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I will go to the altar of God. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Having heard the word of God, let us confess our sins to Him, imploring Him for the sake of His Son, Jesus Christ, to grant us forgiveness. O Almighty God, merciful Father, I, a poor, miserable sinner, confess unto you all my sins and iniquities with which I have ever offended you, and justly deserved your temporal and eternal punishment. But I am heartily sorry for them, and sincerely repent of them, and I pray you of your boundless mercy, and for the sake of the holy, innocent, bitter sufferings and death of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to be gracious and merciful to me, a poor, sinful being. God be merciful to you and strengthen your faith.
Amen.
Do you believe that the forgiveness I speak is not my forgiveness, but God's?
Yes.
Let it be done for you as you believe. In the stead and by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely, and may your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. He who calls you is faithful. He will surely do it. Go in peace. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." The Lord's table has been prepared. Please be seated. Take it, eat. Body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
merciful Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve you.
Amen.
Please be seated.
For just standing up for their Christian faith. And I encourage you to do that.
write a letter, talk to them personally, but always do it with your name on it so they know who you are as we stand up for the word of Christ and for Christians everywhere. Does anyone have any questions or comments for the group? All right, the Lord be with you. Somebody, Paul. I'm looking out there. Yes, go ahead, please, Paul.
Pastor, throughout the year we keep you and your wife and two boys in our prayers. Today, with Pastor Appreciation, we'd like to give you a physical representation of our appreciation for all you've done for us. So, this message is for you when you can.
Well, thank you. Once again, I always say this, we are so blessed. We appreciate your comments and your thoughts. I'm now, as you know, the circuit visitor for our circuit, and I know that pastor and people don't always get along as well as we do here at Good Shepherd. So I think that is so important. I hope that you know that I have your support, and my family and I know that we have yours. And that is a great feeling as you come into work every day and as you minister to the flock here at Good Shepherd. The feedback that I get has been positive since I've been here, and I really do appreciate that because we don't see that everywhere. And when God blesses that, it's important to point that out. So, once again, thank you for not only supporting me, supporting Carson, Holden, and especially Tony as well. We did have a great week away this week. We got a couple of days away, Tony and I. Had a great time, and it's wonderful to be back with you. So, the peace of the Lord be with you. Thanks.